In this video, we're going to install Chrome. To do this, we'll first open Safari and in the address bar type in google.com/Chrome. A page similar to the following will appear. Choose the Download Now button. Now we'll select Accept and Install. This will trigger the download, and you can monitor this in the upper right corner, and I can see it in my lower right as well down here. Once it's done downloading, open the Google Chrome.dmg in your Finder. Here's that file, Google Chrome.dmg disk image. Opening a disk image is similar to installing a USB drive. In the same way, it will also open up a hard drive icon on the desktop. This opens the Chrome installer. Simply drag the Google Chrome icon into the applications folder. You might be prompted for your Mac's password, and you'll see that it will copy the Google Chrome to the applications folder on the Mac hard drive. Now you can close this Google Chrome installer window, and also to eject the installer disk image, drag it to the trash bin. You can also delete the disk image itself from your downloads folder. We shouldn't need it on this computer. Now you can run Google Chrome the first time from the applications folder or from searching for it in the Finder window. Here I'm going to double click on it, and the first time you run it, it's going to give this warning message that it came from the internet. Click open here. You'll also be asked the first time when loaded if you'd like to set Google as your default browser and if you'd like to make Chrome better. Select these options and choose Start Chrome. Mac settings will also alert you of this change and ask you if you want to use Chrome. Select that here. While we've loaded Chrome the first time, it's a good idea to pin Chrome to the Mac dock. Right click on the Chrome icon, select options, and choose Keep in Dock. Now, if this is your computer, you'll sign into Chrome. Enter your G Suite email address or Google or Gmail address here, then your password, and I have two-step authentication set up on the computer, so I'll enter in the text code. Signing into Chrome will now sync all of your apps, bookmarks, history, passwords, and other settings, and it'll be permanently tied to this account. We'll select linked data, and this will start the synchronization process. Now you're signed into Chrome, you can bookmark or save passwords, and it'll be in sync with all your other computers. You'll notice all my bookmarks came into this computer very quickly, along with all the other extensions that I had installed on another Chrome device.